In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Dear my students of grade 6 of the American Diploma of Jama International Schools, welcome to a new English online lesson. This is Mr. Amr Gadallah, your English teacher. Our lesson today is Listen to Anyone. All Alone in the Universe. All Alone in the Universe. I hope it will be a useful lesson for you, and I hope you enjoy it and understand it so well. And as we have accustomed, let's have a quick look at the aims of our today's lesson. By the end of this lesson, we will be able to Number 1. To practice proofreading for spelling of the new vocabularies and misspelled words. To practice proofreading for spelling of the new vocabularies and misspelled words. The second aim is to recognize the progressive tenses. To recognize the progressive tenses. And the third aim is to answer exercises related to the lesson. Inshallah, in this lesson, we are going to study or to revise the progressive tenses. Progressive tenses in the present, in the past, and in the future. And we are going to answer exercises related to the lesson. Let's start our lesson with the vocabulary section. So, open your reader's notebook on page 292. Let's start our lesson with the section of vocabulary. This exercise is about prefixes, and we have talked about prefixes many times before. Here we have some groups of words. And we are looking for the best word that completes each group. So we are going to select a word from the word list that completes each group, or the best completes each group. So let's start. Number one, safeguard care. Safeguard care. Now we are searching for the word that best completes the group here, or belongs to this group. We have safeguard care. So the best completes this group is, yes, precaution, precaution. Okay, number two, announce, shout. Announce, shout. Huh? Please hurry up. Yeah, look for a word that best completes this group or belongs to this group. Announce, shout. So we have proclaim. Proclaim. Very good. Number three, stop, avoid. Stop, avoid. We have what? Yes, prevent. Very good. Let's move to number four. Put off, make longer. So the best choice will be what? Yes. Prolong. Prolong. Let's move to number five. Stick out. Stick out. Jut. Stick out. Jut. Heh, the best complete this group will be? Yes. Protrude. 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 Let's move to number six. old, ancient. So the best choice is yes, prehistoric. Prehistoric. Very good. Number 7, demand, condition. Demand, condition. So the best choice is provision. Provision. Yes. Number 8, when, succeed. When, succeed. Prevail. Yes, very good. Prevail. Number 9. Assume. Assume. Or jump to conclusions. Jump to conclusions. So the answer will be what? Yes, prejudge. Prejudge. Very good. Number 10. Method. Technique. So the best choice with process. Very good. Process. Let's move to page 295. Here we are going to talk about the present progressive forms. Present progressive forms. Either present progressive or present perfect progressive. Let's start the exercise. Rewrite each sentence by changing the underlined verb to the verb tense in parentheses. Number 1, I talk to Glenna right now. So we're going to change the underlying verb into present progressive. And as we have said, that present progressive, its form is am or is or are, and it is followed by the present participle or the verb plus ing. So the answer will be I am talking. I am talking to Glenna right now. Yes, very good. Number 2, we go to the movies together. Present perfect progressive. We, present perfect progressive. 12B what? 12B? Have or has. And it is followed by. Yes, very good. Been. Then followed by the present participle. Present participle, it means the verb. Yes, and we add ing to the verb. So the answer will be we have been going. Very good. We have been going to the movies together. Excellent. Number 3, Glenna tries to be nice to you. Here we are going to use present progressive. So Glenna is a singular subject. So the answer will be Glenna is trying. Very good. Number 4, she includes you when we do things. Present perfect progressive. She includes you when we do things. Present perfect progressive. So the answer will be she has been including you when we do things. Very good. Number 5, she hopes I won't show up. We're going to change it into present perfect progressive. She has been hoping. Very good. Number 6, you do not try hard to understand here. Present progressive. So we're going to change it into present progressive. You are not trying. Very good. You are not trying very hard to understand here. Excellent. Now let's move to page 296 in your reader's notebook. Rewrite each sentence by changing the underlined verb to the verb tense in parentheses. Number one, Maureen said that she read about a movie. She read about a movie. And we're going to use past perfect progressive. Past perfect progressive. So the answer will be what? And we have talked about the past perfect. Huh? Its form is had plus the past participle. Yes. But here we are going to use past perfect progressive. So, yeah. The past perfect had. Then it is followed by been. Been is a past participle of be. Then it is followed by the present participle of the verb or the verb plus ing. So the answer will be Maureen said she had been reading about a movie. Maureen said she had been reading about a movie. Okay, number two, she wondered if I wanted to see it with her. We are going to use past progressive. Past progressive, and we have talked about the past progressive, that its form is was and were. Then it is followed by the present participle of the verb or the verb plus ing. So the answer will be here. Huh? Yes, she was wondering if I wanted. She was wondering. Can I say she were? No, because she is the third personal singular. Yes, subject. Okay, so it's a singular subject. So I say she was wondering. Okay, let's move to the third one. I said I planned to see the movie tonight. To see the movie tonight. I planned. And we are going to use past progressive. Yes, we have just said it. Yes, it will be what? Yes, I said I was planning. Yes, I was planning. Number four, the weather person predicted rain. The weather person predicted rain. We are going to use past perfect progressive. Yes, and the answer will be the weather person has or have. No, we're going to, we're talking about past. Yes, very good. So we are going to use had. So the weather person had been and yes, very good. Had been predicting rain. Very good. The weather person had been predicting rain. Number five, we walked for 2 minutes before the rain started. We're going to use past perfect progressive. Past perfect progressive. So had, then been, then the present participle of the verb. So we had been walking for 2 minutes. Very good. We had been walking for 2 minutes before the rain started. The last sentence here, we wrapped by the time we got to the theater. We got to the theater. So we are going to use past progressive. Past progressive, it means was or were, then they, followed by present participle of the verb. So it will be what? We were dripping. Very good. We were dripping by the time we got to the theater. Here in this page, we're going to talk about the future progressive and the future perfect progressive. So we're going to rewrite each sentence by changing the underlined verb to the verb sentence in parentheses. Number one, Maureen goes with them to Berkeley. So we're going to use future progressive. Future progressive. So as we have said, the future progressive tense, huh, we're talking about its form. So it will be will and be, then it is followed by the present participle or the verb with ing. So the answer will be, Marine will be going. Very good, will be going. Okay, number two, she and Glenna talk about this for weeks. She and Glenna talk about this for weeks. Future perfect progressive. So the answer will be she. Now we are talking about future perfect progressive. Future means will. Will, perfect means have. So it will be will have, huh? Yes, then the past participle of be, it will be been, then the present participle or the verb plus ing. So the answer here will be she and the Glenna will have been talking about this for weeks. Okay, number three. Maureen sleeps over at Glenn's house the night before. Future progressive. Future progressive. So it will be, the answer will be what? Maureen, huh, will be sleeping. Very good. Will be sleeping. Number four, they travel by car to Borthwick. Future progressive. Again, future progressive. Future means well, progressive. So it is followed by be, then the present participle of the verb. So it will be, they will be traveling by car. Number five, Mr. Flyber prepares the boat all day. Future perfect progressive. So the answer will be, Mr. Flyber will have been preparing. Yes. Number six, they will spend lots of time in or on the water. Future progressive. So we are going to use future progressive. So it will be, they will be spending, will be spending lots of time in or on the water. Let's move to page 298. Look at the underlined pronoun in each sentence. Write the type of pronoun it is on the line. Okay, now we have some pronouns and we will write, yeah, the underlying pronoun in each sentence. We will write the type of the underlying pronoun each sentence. Number one, everyone in town is going to the carnival. So everyone, what kind or what type of pronouns? What type of pronouns is it? Everyone is, do you remember? Everyone, everywhere, Yes, very good. It's indefinite pronoun, indefinite pronoun, indefinite pronoun. Number two, that is where we will go and rise and play games. That, so what kind of pronouns it is? What kind of pronouns is it? It is demonstrative. Yes, very good. Demonstrative pronoun. It is a demonstrative pronoun. Yes. Number three, my brother wants to win a game himself. Himself. Yes. What kind of pronoun is it? What kind of pronoun? Yeah, it is intensive pronoun. Very good. Intensive pronoun. Yes. Number four, I am trying to win a baseball cap for him too. I am trying to win a baseball cap for him too. Him is, yes, very good. An object pronoun. Number five, he doesn't know yet. I think it is so easy. He, it's a subject pronoun. Very good. I love surprising someone. Yeah, someone, somewhere, huh? Anyone, all of these are indefinite pronoun. Very good, indefinite pronoun. Excellent. Let's move to another exercise. Okay, let's move to the second exercise. Replace any unclear pronouns. Write the new sentence on the line. The sentence here, number seven, the pirate ship ride is exciting because of how far they swings back and forth. So now we are searching for what? For the pronoun. Yes, unclear pronoun. So where is the pronoun? The pirate ship ride is exciting because of how far they. So this is the pronoun. So, it is related to whom? To the pirate ship or ride? The pirate ship ride. Yes, very good. So now the unclear pronoun is they. And the right answer will be what? Will be the pirate ship ride is exciting because of how far it swings back and forth. Number eight, I want a teddy bear and plastic ring, but you don't know what to do with it. So we are looking for the unclear pronoun. I want a teddy bear and a plastic ring, but you, we have here, you, a pronoun, don't know what to do with it. This is another pronoun. So let's go to the meaning according to the context. I want a teddy bear and a plastic ring, but you don't know what to do with. Can I say with it? With what? What to do with? The teddy bear and the plastic ring. So they are plural object. So I'm going to say what? I want a teddy bear and a plastic ring, but you don't know what to do with them. Yes. Excellent. Very good. On page 299, correct the underlined verb phrases. Write the new sentence on the line. Sentence number one. I was laughing and going on the rides. I was laughing and going on the rides. But I am not enjoying myself. I am not enjoying myself. So here we want to correct the underlined, yes, the underlined verb phrase. Look here at the sentence. I was laughing. So what is the tense here? The tense here is past progressive or past progressive. Yes. So the second sentence is present progressive. No, that's wrong. They should be the same. Yes. So the right answer is I was laughing and going on the rides, but I wasn't enjoying myself. Very good. Number two, they will be going on vacation together. They will be going on vacation together and I was staying at home. They will be going on vacation. Now we're going to talk about future. We have what we have. Future progressive will be going. And here in the second sentence, I was staying. We have past progressive. So that's wrong. So the right answer will be what? They will be going on vacation together. And I will be staying at home. Very good. Number three. I have known Maureen for 8 years. I have known Maureen for 8 years. But I am only knowing Glenna for 6 years. Here I have known, and the second sentence was, I am. So, I have known Maureen, it is present perfect. That's right, it is present perfect. So, the second sentence should be present perfect. Yeah, but I have only known Glenna for 6 weeks. For 6 weeks. Very good. Number four. I am going to the river. So this is present progressive. Where are you coming with me? This is the past progressive. A question in the past progressive tense. So that is wrong. So the right answer will be, I am going to the river. Are you coming with me? That is the right tense and the right answer.